I Can't Do That by Alexander Devonport. This is a story about a girl called Jill. Jill liked to play with her toys in her bedroom. Her favorite toy was a pirate ship. She called it the Fearful Sea Dagger. Pirate ships were supposed to have names like that. Jill loved to pretend that she was sailing the Fearful Sea Dagger through the ocean and fighting sea monsters. One day, Jill imagined her ship was in a terrible storm. The Fearful Sea Dagger was being tossed and turned. Jill threw the boat into the air, and it came down with a crash. The Fearful Sea Dagger's mast had broken off. Jill was no longer imagining she was in the ocean fighting a monster in a storm. She was in her room, and her favorite toy was broken. "Oh no," she said. She held it in her arms, feeling sad and guilty. "I wish I hadn't been so rough with it." She looked at the boat and wondered if she could fix it. "I can't do that," she said. Not knowing what to do, she went to see Mummy and Daddy. They would know what to do. Mummy was sitting at the breakfast table, surrounded by papers and working on her laptop. "Can you fix this, please, Mummy?" asked Jill.
"Sorry, chicken," said Mummy.
"I can't do that. I'm working on our taxes."
"Ask your father."
Jill didn't know what taxes were, but she knew it made grown-ups grumpy. So she left Mummy alone and went to find Daddy. Daddy was in the kitchen washing dishes. "Can you fix this, please, Daddy?"
"Sorry, Poppet," said Daddy.
"I can't do that. I'm busy washing dishes. Ask your brother." Jill didn't know why grown-ups kept cleaning things, but she knew to leave Daddy alone for a while. She went to see her big brother, Tom. Tom was in his room playing a game on his computer. He was always in his room playing a game on his computer.
"Can you fix this, please, Tom?" asked Jill.
"Sorry, sis," said Tom. "I can't do that. I'm in the middle of a raid."
Jill didn't know what a raid was, and she didn't think it was too important. But she left Tom alone anyway. Jill went back to her room. It seemed a lot emptier without her favorite toy. No Fearful Sea Dagger meant no ocean with monsters in it. She felt alone. She felt sad. Jill started to cry. Jill sat on the floor, crying quietly, looking at the Fearful Sea Dagger. What could she do? It needed fixing.
"I can't do that," she said to herself.
Jill stared at the pirate ship in front of her. What is something that can fix things? She wondered.
Wait, sticky tape can fix things, she said. Do I have sticky tape?
Jill did have sticky tape. She remembered her daddy had bought it for her. She found the sticky tape in a drawer.
Okay, here I go, she said.
It was tricky at first, but after a few tries, Jill managed to wrap some tape around the Fearful Sea Dagger's mast, taping it back onto the ship. Jill felt proud that she affixed her toy, but it didn't look like a real pirate ship anymore. Pirates don't use sticky tape. Then she saw an old shoelace on the floor.
I know,
Jill thought.
I can wrap the shoelace around the tape and make it look like a rope.
Jill felt really happy. She had been able to fix her toy all by herself. She picked up the Fearful Sea Dagger and began to imagine that the storm was over and was sailing off into the sunset. Then Jill started to imagine what other things she could fix when she grew up. Things like cars and bikes and even boats. If someone asked her if she could fix or make something, Jill would say,
I can do that!
The end.